Are those stupid chickens still not dropping for you? Do you want even more reasons to be going to Firelands every week? Does your guild still not have that blue baby dragon? Do you want to be sick and tired of the color orange? Are you tired of the current expansion but just can't quit the game for some reason? If you answered yes or no to any of these questions, you know why you're here. Before we get started, if your friends don't play WoW, you don't have an active guild, you're uncomfortable with making groups in the group finder, or you want to do this as solo as possible, I recommend doing this on a mage, shaman, or warlock. Because this legendary was meant for caster DPS, this questline can be done on a druid, mage, priest, shaman, or warlock. If your class is hybrid, you do not have to be in the caster spec to do this. So if you want to do this on a guardian druid, you are more than welcome to. This quest chain will take you at least 8 weeks to complete if you're super diligent and do it every single week, but don't hurt yourself. Also, this mount, quote unquote, does not count for the mount counter because it's tied to the weapon and you're not learning anything from it. So sorry to disappoint you. There are a lot of small story quests in this questline that I will not be including in the chapters of this video. Instead, I will only be including the quests that require an explanation to some degree, or I have some garbage I want to discuss about a certain quest, which I have indicated in the chapters, so you are welcome to listen to that if you really want to. To start the questline, you'll need to pick up a legendary engagement from Corridormi if you're Alliance, or Zeradormi if you're Horde. Corridormi is found in the Mage Tower in the Mage Quarter. If you're porting into it, she'll be on the right. If you're walking into it, she'll be on the left. Zeradormi is in the back right-hand corner of Gromash Hold in the Valley of Strength. If you've never done the Firelands raid on that character, the quest will not be there. Don't panic. You'll have to head over to Mount Hyjal and enter the Firelands raid, killing the first Molten Lord that patrols the bridge. The quest, Your Time Has Come, should pop up. After you accept a legendary engagement from your faction's respective bronze dragon, you can talk to her again to teleport you right in front of Anachronos in the Caverns of Time for the next quest. If for some reason she does not offer to teleport you, the Alliance Caverns of Time portal will be directly behind you. The Horde Caverns of Time portal is on the left and down a flight of stairs in the Pathfinder's Den. The next quest, A Wrinkle in Time, is a cinematic. Watch it or don't. The next quest is All-Seeing Eye. This quest requires you to collect 3 Sands of Time and 25 Eternal Embers. The Sands of Time can be purchased from Yasmin at the Oasis of Versar in the northwest corner of Uldum. If the item is red, it just means you don't have Cataclysm Alchemy level 75 and means nothing to us. If for some reason you can't afford the Sands of Time, you can actually get a slight discount if you talk to Zeradormi in Ramkahen to transport you to the present Uldum with all the old god corruption, if you weren't there already. If you're revered or exalted with the Battle for Azeroth reputation, the Uldum Accord, you'll receive the respective reputation discount, which isn't really a lot, but it's there if you want or need it. Don't go out of your way to farm the rep though, it does not matter. The 25 Eternal Embers come from the bosses of Firelands. By virtue of this raid becoming a timewalking raid during Cataclysm Timewalking, you can do it twice in 1 week, once on normal and once on heroic. 10 and 25 man don't exist anymore, so no, you can't do it 4 times in a week. Unfortunately, there is a chance you can get 0 embers from a boss. Depending on your luck, this could take a while. It should take you about 2 weeks to do this though, running the raid a total of 4 times. Something important you should know is that the Eternal Embers, as well as the Sands of Time, can be sold to a vendor, so don't accidentally sell them if you need bag space while running the raid. Once you have all of the items, return to Anachronos in the Caverns of Time for the next quest. Anachronos will smoosh the items you collected together, creating the Timeless Eye. His next quest, On a Wing and a Prayer, requires you to go to the Kuldara in Borean Tundra. Do not forget to loot a Timeless Eye. Okay, so about that, I was going to put a stupid joke here about how if you forget to loot the Timeless Eye, you'd have to go all the way back and fly over again, only to realize as I was filming this that you don't. You don't need to pick up the Timeless Eye. You can completely forget to pick it up and the cinematic will start playing anyway. You would not believe how surprised I was because I was convinced that it wouldn't let you continue, and I swear it used to not let you. Great to know they've made progress here. Anyway, sorry for interrupting. Upon entering the subzone, a cinematic will play, watch it if you'd like, and pick up the next quest from Terragosa. Her quest, Through a Glass Darkly, is bugged. Still, in the year of our Lord, 2022.
Hi, sorry for interrupting again. So they fixed the bug I was going to talk about. Thank God, I guess. But they foiled my plan to tell you how to fix it and I would be the savior of the universe or whatever. Thankfully for me, I guess when they fixed it, they broke something else. Typical, am I right? So while I was recording the bit of me thinking I was going to show you the bug I thought I was going to talk about, I found a different bug. One of the sentinels will evade you and you can't continue the quest because they have Terragosa subdued and you have to follow her. My strat was literally just run ahead like I was going to tell you for the other bug and that was it. But really, I think the bug was on my part because I was so shocked and surprised again that I just stood there like Terragosa. And the sentinel that spawns right next to the doorway after the Draconid show up is the one that evades on the later platform. And I didn't kill it right there. So, anyway.
Head over to the Nexus Dungeon, which is the bottommost instance portal in the central spire. Once you walk in, talk to Terragosa and follow her around, killing the mobs that approach. Once you get to the Hall of Stasis, she's gonna bug out, but don't worry about it. If you don't make it to the doorway in time and the ice wall appears, kill the mage hunters that spawn. They now unfreeze the door. Yippee. And make sure you kill the extra sentinel that spawns because he will cause other problems for you, and then you'll have to reset the dungeon. If you do forget to kill it, leave the instance, reset all instances, and do the whole thing over again, while also killing the extra sentinel. Continue onwards, kill more mobs that approach, and when you get to the end of the hallway, you'll have to wait a whole whopping minute for Terragosa to break the ice wall, because I guess the dog was supposed to take longer to kill, and the quest designers didn't think about players doing this questline in the future. Make your way over to the other side of the rift by jumping on the discs. And when you make it, if you get over there before Terragosa, wait at the bottom of the ramp because she will not do anything if you aren't in the right spot. 2010-2011 coding, I guess.
Kill Theranar and click the Timeless Eye, which will start a cinematic. Skip it if you'd like, or DBM will do it for you.
Talk to Terragosa and pick up the next quest, Actionable Intelligence, where you get to speak to the guy who fucked a landmark. He has 6 total polygons on his face. You know him. You probably don't love him. The one, the only, Caligos!
Congrats on getting a new model, you ugly bitch.
Funnily enough, he gives you the worst quest in the entire chain. How oddly fitting. Delegation is probably when a lot of you will be joining us.
Hi, welcome. It's nice to have you here.
For some reason, the quest designers decided to not tell you how to do this quest at all in-game. God bless the users of Wowhead. Where would we be without them?
I will shortly regurgitate all of their information at you while making jokes and edits that only I will think are funny.
For this quest, you have to collect special rocks during the encounters of the first 4 bosses. Smush them together and place the aggregate rock on the ground to have it interact with a special boss ability. Lord Ryolith is the easiest, Bestalik comes a close second, Alisrazor is the most annoying, and Shanix requires you to have at least 1 friend and is therefore the worst. He is the reason why you might want to do this solo as a mage, shaman, or warlock. However, before you go in there guns blazing, do not kill any of them when you are done. If you want to do this quest chain as quickly as possible, you need to leave them alive for the next quest. To pick up more bullshit, because... yay!
Starting with Lord Ryolith, purple rocks that look like grapes will spawn on the edge of the arena near the lava as you hit him. You need to collect 3. Also, just melee him. Don't cast abilities on him. And if you're worried you might kill him with melees, take off your gear and don't be in a melee spike if you are. Additionally, if you're doing it on normal, you might have to reset the fight to get a third rock. Squish the rocks together and place the dull focus under his foot before he casts Concussive Stomp. Loot the charge version and hearth away or die in some lava. Moving on to Bethtalik, aggro her, but do not go up to the web. Wait for and kill the Cinderweb drone, which will physically drop 3 blue rocks. Loot them and smoosh them together into a dull focus. Next, go up to the web via the Cinderweb spinners and wait for Beth to use her Smoldering Devastation ability at 0 energy. Also, stay away from the orange pools. Those are meteors and will knock you back down to the lower level. She loses energy quite quickly during the fight, and the timer for Smoldering Devastation will move very fast, so you'll need to place the focus down a lot sooner than you'd think. Loot the charged version, and try your best to hearth away with these goddamn bugs! Keep in mind that the focuses have time limits. It shouldn't be so much of a problem for Bethtalik or Lord Ryolith, but it might for Alyssa Zorg because she is so goddamn annoying, and her fight is so goddamn long. Alyssa Zorg! You stupid chicken! You're definitely gonna want to do her fight on heroic. Start the fight, but do not collect her feathers to fly up. Wait for Druids of the Flame to airdrop 2 molten eggs at a time, which will spawn voracious hatchlings. Underneath them will appear orange popcorn kernels. Do not- What the fuck? That's not what I wrote! Underneath them will appear orange popcorn kernels. Not after you kill them, they poop them out after they hatch, or something. You'll of course need 3. She has 4 phases. If you do this on normal, only 2 eggs will spawn in the first phase. After the 4th phase, she will go back to the first phase and 2 more eggs will spawn. However, on heroic, in just the first phase, 6 of them will spawn no less. Rather excessive, isn't it? Combine the kernels and wait around until after Fiery Vortex. Do not place the focus during Fiery Vortex. She will land with no energy and will not attack in the third phase. Don't place the focus then neither. I originally wrote in the script for you to do that, but since it's time sensitive and I didn't even do that when I was recording this, I ultimately decided to change it. Don't kill the adds that are rekindling her because they help her gain energy faster. In the fourth phase, she'll reach 50 energy and start meleeing you a bunch until she has full energy. Place the focus then. Once she has full energy, she will knock you backwards and charge the focus. Loot the charged version, and you can actually walk through the firewall at the entrance to the arena, so just jump in some lava. Or you can hearth. And now it's time for the dreaded Snake Man. No, not that one. Shanix. Grab your friend or a stranger in the group finder, or just be a mage, shaman, or warlock. Warlocks, you should use your Voidwalker for the taunt, and mages, you should be in Frostbeck if you weren't already, and not be talented into Lonely Winter, or if that's even how it works for you people in the far future. For non-lunar classes, engage the boss like normal, but only kill Rageface because he's annoying. For mages and warlocks, have your pet engage the boss with either a taunt or a regular attack, and then set them to passive. To be safe and not accidentally kill Shanix, always attack Rageface. For shamans, activate your Earth Elemental before engaging and without targeting anything. Once it's active, again, only attack Rageface. In order for the item, Focus Crystals, to spawn, someone must walk into the crystal traps. It can be you, your friend, or Riplim, but it cannot be your pet. Shamans, it will have to be Riplim, otherwise you will get stuck because Earth Elementals are not pets and cannot be controlled. Once the trap has been activated, whoever walked into it will be stuck in a crystal prison. Break them out, and the focus crystal will be on the ground. You will need to collect 3 one final time. Shamans, you will have to do this twice because your Earth Elemental will not last long enough for you to pick up a third. If Riplim stepped on a trap, he will get a buff that prevents him from triggering another trap for 15 seconds. Keep in mind that Shanix drops 2 kinds of traps and Riplim can walk over both. If you were doing this by yourself and you walked onto the trap, target the trap and order your pet to attack it.
It should stay on passive once the prison is dead, but if not, set it back manually. To charge the combined focus crystal, you need it to get hit by Shanix's Pearl Spear ability. There will be an orange rune indicating where he will throw it, and you should know where to place it. It's a fucking orange rune, come on. Loot the charged version and die in some lava once you're not be getting pulled by something. Shanix, I don't know why it fucking does that. You can't jump into the lava the first couple of times because Shanix says,
no. No. Like Gollum.
Now that you have all four crystals, smush them together and head over to the Circle of Thorns adjacent to Beth Tulik's lair. Head into the portal, kill the Harbingers of Flame, and attempt to loot the branch of Nordrassil. Defeat the Tormented Protector and listen to his RP. Relieving him of his duties will grant you the title Blessed Defender of Nordrassil, but only for 2 hours. Kill Volcanus and actually loot the branch of Nordrassil. Then turn the quest into Kaelic at Amber Ledge in Boreen Tundra. His next quest, Nordrassil's Bow, you have to watch him spit on the branch. Thank you so much. His next quest, Emergency Extraction, has you talk to him to watch a cinematic, to watch Terragosa fucking die.
Oh, she passed away? Aww. All right.
Hence the name of the legendary. His next quest, At One, no, not As One, Kaelic will then put you into a ball, and you and Terragosa will be a part of each other. Aww. Finally, he gives you a substantive quest. Time grows short. For this quest, you need to collect 1,000 seething cinders from the bosses of Firelands. Yes, 1,000. This is why you don't want to kill them during delegation. Thankfully, these drop more frequently than the Eternal Embers, but you still have to collect 1,000 of them. This should take you about 3 weeks, running the raid a total of 6 times. If you complete the quest and still have a few bosses left to kill, leave those bosses alive so you can collect more stuff later. Once you have all of them, return to Kaelic at the Kuldara in Boreen Tundra. Afterwards, he'll give you the quest Alignment, where you get to watch a cinematic of him destroying Aragos with facts and knowledge to become the CEO of the Blue Dragonflight. He'll then give you the quest Heart of Flame, where you get to kill even more bosses of the Firelands. Yay! You need to collect 250 Smoldering Essences and 1 Heart of Flame. To collect the Smoldering Essences, you will need to equip the Rune Staff of Nordrassil. While targeting a dead boss, either right-click the weapon or, after dragging it onto your bar, press a button. Ahahaha! You will know if they haven't been absorbed because they will have the Smoldering debuff and will also be covered in orange goo. Ragnaros is the only boss that you cannot absorb. Bosses will not disappear if you forget to absorb them during a run. However, they will disappear if you leave the instance for a few days. I'm not sure why you would do that, and I'm not sure why I wrote that either. If you have skinning, do not skin Beth Tulik until after you've absorbed her. She and the smoldering essences will disappear. Collecting these will take you at least 3 weeks, running the raid a total of 6 times, just like the Seething Cinders. The Heart of Flame will physically drop from Ragnaros once you have all 250 smoldering essences and you have the weapon equipped. Wait for him to give you the Rage of Ragnaros debuff before you kill him. If he doesn't give it to you, restart the fight and equip the weapon. If it still doesn't appear,
you can suffer for all I care.
Honestly though, if it still doesn't appear, something is wrong with the game. The debuff is triggered by the weapon being equipped, and you have all 250 smoldering essences when you engage Ragnaros. You might not have all 250, or it's a bug with no workaround. In that case, you'll have to submit a bug report. Once you have everything, if you're Horde, return to where you picked the very first quest up from Zeradormi and speak to Halagosa right next to her. If you're Alliance, speak to Halagosa in the Cathedral District. She will give you the quest, The Stuff of Legends. Follow her around to get monologued at by Kaelagos. Turning this quest in will finally complete the questline and give you the weapon. Congratulations! 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 You toiled hard enough, and the weapon is now yours. And now everyone knows that you're a Scaly before Dragonflight is out. Unless it already is.
guess the joke doesn't really land.
If you want to transform into the dragon on a regular basis, I'll include a macro in the description for you. Thank you so much for watching my video. I'm happy to have helped you on this arduous journey. I don't normally make content like this, so I'm sorry to disappoint you if you're looking for more. But if for some reason you do like the normal videos that I make, I appreciate you. Again, thank you for watching my video, and I hope you have an amazing day.